Hey folks, good morning or good afternoon. So today I wanted to take a picture of Eagle Nebula. If you saw the movie Contact, it will actually show the pillars of creation. Pillars of creation you must have seen from the Hubble telescope. It's like 7,000 light years away from us, so it takes 7,000 years if you travel at the speed of light to get there. So we can really go there with our current technology. So we wanted to use the telescope technology to bring the nebula to us. Basically it's a kind of called like a star, like queen of all the nebulas. It's one of the beautiful nebulas to watch. It's called Eagle Nebula. Today I want to take a picture of it. Right now I pointed my Celestron HSC telescope. This is the AVX mount. It is polar aligned. Right now it is pointed to the Eagle Nebula at this point. It's the ZWO071 monochrome color, one shot color. Hyperstar is plugged in so that I can take a little faster. I don't have much time today, so I just wanted to complete that in like an hour, in like 1 hour. That's the plan. I'll show you my workflow and talk about it. So how am I planning to take this picture of Eagle Nebula? Well, I did the polar align using the sharp cap. I used the sequence generator pro tools, framing and focus wizard to create the sequence. So the sequence gave me the location of Eagle Nebula, the array and the deck. So I configured the plate solver to plate solve for this coordinates. So I slewed to the telescope to that coordinates. Once that is done, I tested a little bit, checked my framing, my focus and all, set my temperature of my camera to like 20 degrees. Right now, I mean, I set it to 15. It's right now to like showing 16.9. This is the stretched histogram. Like right now, the readout, the mean readout is like 185. I think that's pretty much what I'm getting. I mean, I'm not using any narrow band filters. I'm just using the one shot color. So I'm still getting the 185 readout, which is still pretty good. As I was telling you before, I'm using Hyperstar, so I used 5 seconds exposures. Right now I'm taking 200 exposures. So once that is done, I'm going to check and see how the picture comes out. So if you are curious on how the picture is coming, this is how it looks like. It's in black and white. I auto stretched it. So you can see the histogram is looking okay. You know, it's picking up a lot of light. If I zoom in, I don't think I'll see any better unless I stack it. So that's pretty much where it is. I'm guessing this is actually kind of on the inverted side, like 90 degrees. So this is the eagle, I'm guessing. So let's see how it comes out. So finally I took 670 pictures last night. Each one of them is like 5 seconds. I wrote these frames directly to the external hard drive. I took 50 dark frames earlier. I took 30 flats.
Use deep sky stacker to stack it. And stacking in Pixinsight, I opened, and here is the stretched picture of it. And if I extract the background using the automatic background, here is the extracted picture. Let me stretch this again. So this is the Eagle Nebula. There is an option called Photometric Color Calibration. So if you open your original pictures, the one that you took, and if you say acquire from the image, it brings that array and the deck from that image. So you could use the photometric color calibration. It's actually going to plate solve it, and then it does the background neutralization based on the plate solving parameters, and also it color calibrates. The default color calibration versus this one, I think photometric color calibration seems to be a much better one. You could pick where you wanted to acquire the data from. Once plate solving is done and color calibration is done, it is going to show you a picture like this. Sometimes actually completes the color calibration. Sometimes you may have to do a background extraction again to make. So I did a dynamic crop to, and I did an ABE before so that the picture. This is a wide field telescope. I really don't need all these stars. Actual size of the picture that actually shows the Eagle Nebula. So once I rotate 180 degrees, now you can see the structure of the eagle and the pillars of creation itself. Let me zoom in. So, you know, this is the tall pillar, and, you know, this is the small one, and this is the smallest one. I could do some noise reduction on this one. Was there before, like all these colors, and once I apply that, that was gone. To convert this from the linear image, I'm applying the histogram function. So here is my final image. I hope you like it. Don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.